What is up, party people? Okay, welcome back to another episode of Body Language Podcast. Fucking thank you guys for coming to another episode and visiting our channel, showing us love. I really appreciate it. Episode 18, 19, 25. Whatever. Yeah, man. Oh my God. We've been a channel for a month. Actually, less than a month. Like 27 days. Okay? No, it's not true at all. 21 days. We've been a channel for 21 days. And we have almost 1,000 views. Thank you. God, you guys are awesome, dude. Like 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70 views per video. Like, I didn't know it was going to be like that, dude. I got to up my ante on my fucking content. All you people are going to be watching. I mean, fuck, I didn't know it was going to be like that, dude. Shit. Thank you guys, man. That's awesome. You guys are awesome. Thanks for checking out all my guests and all my podcasts. And not mine, our. Mine and my guests, my wife and I. Anyway, you guys are awesome. Thank you. Happy fucking Monday. Hope it was great. If it wasn't, tomorrow's a new day. Yeah, man, it's fucking good to see you guys. Missed you guys. It's been a mo. The upload schedule probably doesn't seem like there's much lag in between uploads, but there's... I mean, we started filming the week of Christmas, and we're just now caught up to where we're uploading as we record. So, you know, been a while. But yeah, dude, good to see you guys. Like and subscribe if you haven't. If you have, thank you very much. What are you doing in there? Hey. What are you doing in there? Why? Don't be ugly to me. Why? Okay, thank you, love you. Anyway, yeah, the fucking last episode we shot with Nick and Kuz and Jeff, finally you guys know who Jeff is, dude. 20 episodes in almost, and you guys are just now meeting Jeff. You'll see a lot more of him, he's great. Jeff, man, love Jeff, dude, he's the shit, it's funny. But yeah, dude, we got to, we'll just say an undisclosed location for the last episode, because I'm pretty sure the people who live there wouldn't want me to give away their digs. But anyway, we had a microphone go out, so we, like, so it was four guys. It was me and Jeff, Nick, and Kuz, and I had three microphones set up. One to go. One to go in between Jeff and me, and then one to go on the other side of Nick and Kuzma. So it was going to be like here's a circle, two here, one here, we're all speaking in the middle, and it was going to be perfect. But one of the fucking mics went out, so we were gonna have four, but we went to three. I'm sorry, I said three. I meant to say four. Yeah, dude, it just... we were gonna have like a boom mic and then three here, but we only had two here and one boom mic. Either or, you guys seem to like it, so thanks for fucking tolerating that, because that was like, I got really upset and nervous that night about that shit, because it was pissing me off. It was I don't know, just really fucking aggravated me, because I had all that shit worked out beforehand, and then it just fell the fuck apart last minute. But thank you guys for hanging in there, man, and digging it. Appreciate that shit. Yo, so I've been hearing a lot about this, and I may be a little late on this, but this whole Papa John N-word thing. Dude said the N-word, and now it's a bunch of like under a bunch of scrutiny for saying the N-word. I don't know, man. Like, the interviews seem pretty true. The recordings and the tapes seem pretty true. Yeah, seem pretty fucking like, yeah, no, you said the N-word on camera. He was on the H3 podcast today. And I must say, I kind of buy his story a little bit. It seems like the public kind of overly divulged his situation, bulged it out more than it should have been. Before the interview, before the H3 podcast, I kind of was like straight up like, yeah, fuck Papa John. Yeah. And he, you know, like, you can't say the N-word, man. Just, that's like the one word in the whole world that you can't. You can say cunt. You can say fag. You can say queer. Say fuck, shit, goddamn. Cannot say the N-word. Asshole, son of a bitch, piece of shit, douchebag, any of them, any word. I'm pretty sure nobody that gets offended by any of those words. There's one word that people will get offended by. Can't say that word, okay? Because if you do, you're canceled. So. But anyway, yeah, it's crazy, man. Like, I much like my Trump view and preference, I feel like, I don't know, I thought one way, and then I heard the interview, and I thought another way. I don't know, man, but Papa John, dude, that's like a left field saying the fucking N-word, bro. Goddamn. Get your shit together as a fucking pizza mogul. I'm gonna catch that fucking fly, motherfucker. Okay, anyway, Papa John, saying the N-word, what the fuck? Leave your comments, leave your thoughts below, okay? Oh, also, speaking of comments below, I've got nothing but love since we started this podcast. Thank you so much for all that. If you guys want to be on the podcast, hit me up, hit Jessica up. If you guys have any podcast suggestions or notes, ways that you think that we could make the podcast better, segments that you guys would like for me to touch on. Like, this is that's what's so beautiful about the podcast, is that it's a like an open conscious platform. You have to be able to take notes and criticism from your audience, because that's what they, you know, that they're subconsciously, in a weird way, the writers of your show. So I am totally open to that. If you want to be in the podcast, come sit on the couch with me. We'll bring you some Mountain Dew. We'll give you a $20 bill, pack of cigarettes if you smoke. Dude, we'll hang out. We'll have a good time. We'll feed you jambalaya or some tacos. You know, note me. Let me know. Let me know how we can make the podcast better. Because we don't know what we're doing, and we're just winging it. So leave comments, only if they're positive comments. Don't leave anything ugly. We don't want to hear anything like that. You know, let us know what's up. But we're about 6 or 7 minutes into this podcast. We're going to go ahead. I'm going to finish my glass of wine after this. But before we do that, we're going to take a 30, well, you know, we'll give them a minute. We'll give Gulf to Go a minute. We're going to give our fucking sponsor a goddamn shout out. Gulf2Go.com. Okay. Gulf2Go.com. Fast food, surf and turf, pizza, ice cream, barbecue, organic, vegan options. Gulf2Go.com, link in description. We have a home app, home page, home number. Link in description, Gulf2Go.com. We're the smoothest, most handsome, most punctual, most dope, unique, genuine surf and turf, fast food, pizza delivery from South Foley to West Pensacola. If you're in Gulf Shores, Orange Beach, Foley, Alberta, Pensacola, Perdido Key, give Gulf to Go a fucking call. We will not disappoint. I saw today on Facebook randomly how my buddy Brandon, he called Waiter and they stiffed him for $70 and then claimed that they passed the delivery off to another driver and that driver gave that delivery to somebody else. With no give a shits from waiter a single bit. Our company, golf2go.com, will never do that to you. We will deliver your food between an hour and 15, and sometimes even 45 minutes or less, with a smile, a good greeting, hot food, and for the most part, we're humans, we fuck up, but all of your order, okay? We fucking will get all of your order as you request. 1 out of 5 times, they may mess it up, but they are so good at making up for it. Coupons. Knocks off the top off the next order. I mean, what the hell else do you want, baby? Come on. Golf2go.com has everything that you want. And by that, I mean everything but cigarettes and liquor. When it comes to food, ice cream, pizza, burgers, seafood, we have over a 100-mile radius delivery. We are $3 cheaper than your general delivery service. Generic delivery service at that. Give Golf2go at. Dude, give Golf2go. Like I said, today, randomly, saw this fucking awful situation that this gentleman was put in with waiter. Don't fuck with waiter. Don't fuck with Uber Eats. Don't fuck with DoorDash. Golf2go.com. That's the way to go. If you want some seafood, we'll bring it to you. You want some pizza, some burgers, some Coca-Cola, Sprite, bunch of ice cream, whatever the fuck, we'll bring it to you. Give us a call. Golf2go.com. Smoothest, most handsome, punctual, dope-ass delivery. South Foley, West Pensacola. Give us a call. Golf2go.com. You know, honestly, now that I'm like reflecting back on this podcast, there's like nothing about this podcast that is even worth visiting. It is a literal absolute nothing podcast. But that's why I do these soft casts. It's like 20, 30, 35 minute episodes of just me just ranting and talking shit, checking in with everybody. For those of you who give a shit about me, most of you don't, not a big deal. I'm not affected by it. I love podcasting. I'm going to podcast regardless. I'm going to get better at this. I'm going to do something with this. Period. It's going to happen. I don't even fucking question it. Gotta have a few boring podcasts, a few aimless podcasts, excuse me, a few random podcasts, if you will, to get to something that's juicy. Yes, Body Language is a fucking guest-orientated podcast. Yes, it is. But that doesn't keep me from wanting to create and fucking do my own singular solo podcast. I dig it. I'm into it. I like it. For those of you who do like it, like me, I appreciate it. Thank you for your love. This will probably be the last podcast that we don't have like the iPad back with us or a notepad, because we're going to start doing segments. We're going to start making these little short soft casts a little bit more juicy, a little bit more watchable, a little bit more bite size. Yeah. So, you know, thanks for that. You know, we're gonna, you know, take your bullshit criticism and all the negative things you say about our podcast, hone them, put them on a pad, and fucking re-deliver them to you. But anyway, yeah, softcast, shortcast. I've been really harping on this fucking Kobe situation. Like, I know everyone's been bringing this up, everyone's been talking about it, but I stay really plugged into the comedy world, and there's just a lot of backlash over the situation. It's just awful, man. Hearts and condolences to all the members of the family that lost someone in that shit. Just hits home for me, man. I was at my buddy Nick's house. Not true. I was at a random stranger's house with my buddy Nick a few days ago, and we were playing Beer Jam. Which is like a play on play of Can Jam. If you guys know what that is, you know. If not, just Google it. Can Jam, Beer Jam. You'll find out in like 2 seconds. It's a very simple game. But we were playing that, and then it was like 30 or 40 of us, and there was a bunch of families there, and like ladies with their kids, and my wife and my beautiful children were there. And man, just like, I don't know, man, I was a little buzzed and a little stoned, and looking back and all these palm trees, you know, coming over this sunset, and like all these beautiful human beings sitting there, and like just having, I don't know, man, I just like, I started, for some reason, Kobe Bryant popped in my mind, man. And it's the, because it's recent, and I don't know, also Mac Miller popped in my mind too, you know, like his new record came out, I've been bumping the fuck out of that. I don't know, man, I just got like super sentimental and super emotional and super like uncomfortable with myself for a moment, because just had like this revelation of how sweet and how short life really is, and it can be sometimes. You know, I don't think we really like, that's not true. I don't want to say we. I feel like there's a lot of you out there that are like me. I'm one of the few that still has a lot of faith in humanity. So I'd like to think that there's a lot of people who are like me out there who feel like fucking, you know, when you think about something like that, it kind of hits like a personal chord, rings a personal bell. It's just hard to imagine, like, leaving my children behind, leaving my wife behind, who is my best friend. It's like really fucking weird to think about. And just, it's really sad to know that other people out there are having to continue their journey without the one that they started it with. And it's sad. So cheers to you guys, man. Just was on my mind. And we were having a good time. Can Jam Beer Jam was great. We were buzzed and all having a good time, bunch of friends. If you didn't know those people there, then you kind of became friends with them afterwards. It's kind of that sort of vibe. But yeah, it was just, I started thinking about that hard, man. Fuck. It's a bummer. Anyway, I have a few segments for tonight. We're going to get into, we're going to actually do our, we've always talked about doing, I've changed the name a few times, but it's called What's Your Color? And it's like the different color of your penis that week. 30 second rant, favorite movie, favorite music of the week. And I noticed this week, because it's the first week to go into the first segment of What's My Color. I noticed that the first part of this last week, I was still very dehydrated and sick. And like my penis was pale as shit. Like it was like a piece of stock mead paper. Like somebody dropped my cock in bleach or something. It was weird. But the more I got hydrated, the more I realized that at 31 years old, water is a huge deal. Doesn't matter if you're sick. Doesn't matter if you're got bad eating habits or whatever the shit may be. Dude, being hydrated, it's kind of like that saying, you can never go wrong with the truth. You can never go wrong with some water, because it will make you look better, feel better, and progress more. Like, I feel like you could... Harlan, come here, buddy. Come here, bud. Come here. Come here, man. He's always intimidated by the microphone. He doesn't like the mics. He doesn't like the cables, because he thinks... He feels like he can't walk on them, which is weird. But anyway, yeah, water is a super, super fucking important. So important. Okay, done with What's My Color. What's My Color? Bleach white, then it's seemingly kind of got its like pink tan tone. Anyway, back this week. music for the week. Dude, I rediscovered Stranglehold. I rediscovered Stranglehold by Ted Nugent this week. God damn, that song goes, dude, that song slaps. That song goes so fucking hard. I feel like my buddy John and Josiah will definitely identify with me on that. Stranglehold, Ted Nugent, rediscovery on music this week with that. That shit was fire. As far as movies go, I rewatched Joker. I'm a little late to the program on that. I was about a month late on that. A, B, did not have the best first impression of that movie, but I'm okay with it now. It's a good movie. I love Joaquin Phoenix. Beforehand, it was probably my least favorite Joaquin role, but I'm digging it now. Yeah, so that's my favorite movie of the week. Music, Stranglehold, Ted Nugent, movie, Joker, Joaquin Phoenix. What's my color? Bleach to normal, cat hair. Yeah, for those of you who are listening to the audio podcast or not watching the visual, cat hair on my couch right in the middle of me saying that. Yeah, so we did some redecorating in the house today. We redecorated the guitars and moved the guitars around. I put some of my old older mixers up on the wall. Got some shit off the old Motorola. That looks pretty good in here. It's kind of like a fucking echo. But anyway, I think we're going to cut this podcast a little short. Thank you guys for coming to the podcast. It's a soft cast. It's a short podcast, soft cast, body language podcast version of a short cast, which is called a soft cast because we put music behind the podcast. If you like the music that you heard in this podcast, the link to that mix is in description. Golf2go.com, arrangement of food, arrangement of love, delivery. We have podcast plans for this weekend and podcast plans twice for next week. So you should have 3 podcasts within the next 10 days, not including this one. So technically 4 if you count 11 days. 4 podcasts next 11 days. Like and subscribe if you haven't already. Take care of yourself. Share and show your friends. We will see you next time. Body Language Podcast, episode 84 and a half.